Hey there, tech enthusiasts, and welcome back to our channel. Today, we're talking about how to factory reset your MacBook Air or any other Mac computer. So if you've ever wondered about how to give your MacBook a fresh start, stick around because we've got some expert tips coming your way. Before we dive in, make sure you give this video a like and subscribe to our channel with notifications turned on. Okay, let's get started. First off, for those using macOS devices with the T2 security chip, the process takes a slight detour. Here's how to do it. Start by powering down your Mac. Next, hold down the power button until your computer turns on and loads the startup options. When you see the options appear, you can release the power button. Next, click Options and press Continue. From the list of options that appear, choose Disk Utility and press Continue. Within Disk Utility, choose your primary disk from the options on the left-hand side and click Erase. Once the process completes, head back to the recovery options and choose Reinstall macOS from the list. Now, if your Mac has Apple Silicon under the hood, the steps are a little bit different. So if you're wondering how to factory reset an Apple Silicon MacBook, here's how to do it. Start by clicking on the Apple menu and choosing Restart. As your Mac is turning back on, press and hold the Command and R keys until you spot that familiar Apple logo. From here, it's disk utility time. As with the T2 chip instructions, choose your primary disk from the options on the left-hand side and click Erase. Once complete, reinstall macOS from the recovery options and your Mac will be reset to factory condition. Remember, every step is just like a puzzle piece. Fit them together just right for that perfect MacBook factory reset. Now, let's see how to factory reset a MacBook without losing any content. This method is a game changer if you've got some valuable files on your computer that you just don't want to lose, and here's how it works. Open the Apple support page on your web browser and log in with your Apple ID. Click on the device you're resetting from the My Devices section. Under Service Coverage, select Cancel or Request a Refund for an AppleCare plan if your device is still within coverage. Next, connect an external hard drive to your Mac or just use a cloud service like iCloud or Google Drive. Next, just copy all the important files and documents from your Mac to the external storage device or cloud service. In macOS Ventura or later, choose the Apple menu and select System Settings. Click on your name and choose Sign Out. For older OS versions, you'll need to navigate to System Preferences, choose Apple ID, click on Overview and sign out from there. Open the Messages app on your Mac. In the menu bar at the top of the screen, click on Messages, select Settings, go to the iMessage tab and click on Sign Out. For Macs that have Apple Silicon, start by clicking on the Apple menu and choosing Restart. As your Mac is turning back on, press and hold the Command and R keys until you spot that familiar Apple logo. From here, it's disk utility time. Choose your primary disk from the options on the left-hand side and click Erase. For Macs with the T2 security chip, start by powering down your Mac. Next, hold down the power button until your computer turns on and loads the startup options. When you see the options appear, you can release the power button. Next, click Options and press Continue. From the list of options that appear, choose Disk Utility and press Continue. Within Disk Utility, choose your primary disk from the options on the left-hand side and click Erase. Close Disk Utility and go back to the macOS Utilities menu. Reinstall macOS from the recovery options and your Mac will be reset to factory condition. So that's how you perform a factory reset on your MacBook, but remember this process is irreversible, so double check your backups before initiating the factory reset on your MacBook. If this guide's helped you hit the reset button on your Mac, don't forget to smash that subscribe button, give us a thumbs up and make sure you turn on notifications. Your support keeps us going and we've got plenty more computer mastery coming your way. If you have any questions or need any extra help, drop a comment down below and we'll see you in the next video.